m. That means we have equal number of a's and b's, whereas number of c's can be anything. So we already solved this kind of problem before. So let us solve this for this example. So how can we derive language for this? You can have equal number of a's and b's. So take a, n values greater than or equal to 1, so that you get a b c or a b b c or a b b c c c and so on. So now tell me, so based on the previous problems, so we need to identify the logic for this kind of problem. So here, as we have equal number of a's and b's, so we can perform push operation for one, for a, and pop operation for b, whereas for c, do nothing. That's the logic. So step one is, if input symbol is a, then perform push operation. If input is b, then pop a from stack. If input is C, do nothing. Okay? So you can repeat the step 1 and step 2 based on the given string. So this is how we can represent this. Take stack with initial element as Z0. If this is your string A, B, B, C, then first A. Push, second A, push A onto stack. If it is B, for first B, pop. For second B, pop A. For C, C means do nothing. Either push or pop, you won't perform anything. And stack remains empty. If we pop this, Z not also. So that's the logic. So let us now write transition functions. So, how to write transition function? Take the string. So, delta of Q naught A Z naught. So, initially, top of the stack is Z naught and input symbol is first A. So, perform push operation. So, it will be Q naught A Z naught. Next, Q naught A A. Next input symbol is also A and top of the stack is A. Input and top of the stack. It gives you, no need to change the state, and push second A onto stack so that you will get A. So this is top of the stack and this is input element. Next, Q naught. If input symbol is B, top of the stack is A, then change state and perform pop operation. Pop this A. Now Q1 B, so this is already popped out with this transition function. Q1 B A means again Q1 pop operation. Pop second A also. Now move to C. Q1 C and top of the stack is Z naught. Do nothing. So just change state and write top of the stack. Next, C again. So this function again, it remains same for any number of C's. So Q1, so now we are at Q2, C, Z naught, it gives you Q3, Z1. So this function is same for any number of C's. Okay, so you need to make it as a self loop. And finally, Q3 input. At the end, you need to place epsilon. So epsilon, top of the stack, Z naught, it gives you Q4, epsilon. So let us see a graphical notation for this transition function. So take states q naught, q one, q two, okay, q three, and q four. So q naught on A comma z naught, it produces A z naught. Remain in same state. Q naught A A. Push A onto stack, remain in same state, again self loop. Next, if input symbol is B and top of the stack is A, then pop operation. If input symbol is B, top of the stack is A, pop operation. So this is same for any number of B's, so make it as a self loop. And now if input symbol is C, okay, C, top of the stack is Z naught. Then remain in same state. So then move to state Q2 and top right top of the stack. Now input is C and top of the stack is Z0. Remain in same state. So sorry, here it should be in same state. Okay, we are not changing any element. C is same. So it is Q2 only and final state will be Q3. Okay, after doing this, now Q2 complete input is process. So now epsilon, top of the stack is Z0. So which is nothing but if you pop the Z0 also, you will get epsilon and you will move from Q2 to Q3, and Q3 is your final state. Okay, so here we should not change the state because input symbol is same, okay, in both the cases. So state remains as it is. So when input symbol is empty, then you need to change the state from Q2 to Q3. And this is how we need to draw this transition diagram or graphical notation for this given transition functions or for the given language.